early ideas about atoms. So back in the 5th century BC, Leucippus and his student Democritus were the first people to propose that matter was composed of small indestructible particles, and they gave those particles the name atomos, or atoms. Democritus wrote, "Nothing exists except atoms and empty space. Everything else is opinion." So these guys were right on track back in the 5th century BC. They proposed that there were many different kinds of atoms that existed, they were different in shape and size, and that they moved randomly through empty space. These guys were pretty insightful considering the level of technology, which was completely non-existent, right? No electricity, nothing back then. So you've probably never heard of Leucippus and Democritus, right? Anybody heard of those guys before? You probably have heard of Plato and Aristotle, though. Those guys are, you know, famous philosophers. They were a lot more popular than Leucippus and Democritus, and they felt that matter did not have any smallest particles, but that you could keep dividing it infinitely. And they said different substances were composed of various proportions of fire, air, earth, and water. And you may have heard of that theory, which we now know is not true. So competing ideas, they had no way to test these ideas. They could just sit around and argue about them. So Aristotle was more popular and influential, and so his view prevailed, which set science back about 2,000 years, because his ideas were wrong, and the correct ideas got pushed aside. The scientific approach to studying matter became the established way to learn about the physical world, and this was based on evidence, experiment, hypothesis, not just thinking about stuff. So English chemist John Dalton, he lived in the late 1700s, early 1800s, he gave convincing evidence to support the ideas of Leucippus and Democritus. Their ideas were correct, but they had no way of supporting those ideas. Still, the debate continued about atoms until 1905, when Einstein kind of settled it with his explanation of Brownian motion.